you can imagine big trees like those. Yeah, that's a big tree.
So it's that deep?
Yes. Huh? That deep. C'est pas un autre qui te m'a fait dire ça. Ben, il m'a montré mon égard sur un chulo. Et on fait amène à pâtir. Amène à pâtir. Non, c'est pérenne.
So it never dry.
No, look at the color of the water.
So to treat this water?
It's cheap. It's very cheap to treat. It's not like the water in Naponde where I'm not the food that I'm done.
Wow.
That is something myself.
It's not time to embarrass about this.
Because both his name means I would see this way.
That's the people whose names are insulting.
And I can't be keeping people whose names are insulting. Ambassador for 30 minutes. Who
is Lina Nui?
Tishan, you are my guy, Zawa. No deep proverbs. My food is I woke up at night and I lose it. But we can't go on your creative.
Yeah. I have to have a point on it.
Yeah, you have a point there as well.
I'm back with it. But I have an uncle. A tongue and a hammer. We have to be vice president to a club. Then I'll join IP.
For them, they will join.
They have signed their line.
Oh, we have to be more good. Now we can see who where it is. Then to the professor. So that it can open up in the area. Very beautiful water.
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Yes, sir.
You
can
breathe. Yes, sir.
Just be careful. Yes, sir. One and both. You are welcome to Kambesh Kota, particularly in Singapore province. Honorable Minister, this is the actual dam. What you are seeing behind there, it's just an impoundment. The actual dam is actually this one.
Okay.
So
So this is a spill to allow the aquatic life on the other side of the river. Uh-huh. And we have got a weir here. There's a small weir that maintains the level of water in the impoundment. Uh-huh. And within this impoundment, we're able to hold about 5 million cubic meters of water in a year.
Yes, okay.
The consumption in Chinsali is 1.5 million cubic meters of water in 1 year. So the excess, about 3.5, is meant for an expansion of development within the district. And initially, we were supposed to do a weir, just a small dam, to impound only enough water for the people of Chinsali. But somewhere in 2012, 2013, is actually very big. It's designed to take up 15 to 20 years. Any population that will come for the future, we still have enough design to cater for that growth. We've also made a visit from here. That is Robert Kapasimakasa. He's connected. It's about 4 kilometers from here. And they are getting water from this plant. Very clean water, very safe. And then we've also connected the bomb from this dam. And the Chinsali is lucky that they've got 2 water sources. This is the most reliable source. The other one we have, which is the spring, is prone to a lot of siltation, especially during the rainy season. But we rely so much on this one. It's able to give us 800 cubic meters of water in a day. And we have also constructed a very big pump station there, which will cut off the reservoirs that have been erected in Chinsali. There are 4 of them, 300 cubic meter one, and 500 cubic meter, we have 3. And these have been segmented. On the old Chinsali, we have put 2 tanks. And the new Chinsali, we have put 2 500. And then also we are doing now the distribution, which is 100% complete now. The contractor next week will start the metering. We promise you, honorable, that in the month of April, we are actually ready to commission this project, the entire project. Because we just gave the contractor some snag list, which he has to finalize. And that is about this project.
So you are now projecting into April.
We can promise still mid March that it will be ready. But in case of any minor, maybe there's a leakage as we are pushing water in the new network, because the new network has been there for over 2 years. So when we push water there, we need to do the flushing and ensure that we do the disinfection as well, together with the tanks which are now complete. So that we are very sure that the lines are not contaminated. So even when people start receiving they are not receiving dead water.
So the contractor is actually working, the works are not stored at all?
The works are not stored. Mm-hmm. We are also thankful that you were able to facilitate somewhere around 8 million. Mm-hmm. So what we are remaining on the certificate is just 1.6 million kwacha, mm-hmm. which I think now we are very active, that we should be able to finish even before that payment of 1.6.
The contractor is not delivering over the 1.6?
No. Okay. We've actually taken them on to ensure that we squeeze the program. We were promising somewhere around April, but we want to finish within 14 days.
Right.
And just to mention the cost, Honorable, initially the cost of this weir was actually about 500,000 kwacha, that time in 2013. But because of the changes, we had to push the cost to 7 million to just do this dam so that we impound enough water for any development within Chinsali. The total cost of the project is 51 million kwacha.
And this is all funded from the treasury, isn't it?
This is 100% funded by government, mm-hmm. and somewhere around 45 million kwacha has already been paid. Mm-hmm. We still have some saving on this project, so we want to extend the network to some need areas within Chinsali, mm-hmm. Just beyond the
Kabuta area.
So that's what we want to take the other distribution. Mm-hmm. So we are sitting with the contractor possibly next week so that we buy most of the distribution pipes so that we take to that area.
Well, this is a minister.
Mm-hmm.
The success story.
Yeah.
Around His Excellency's vision to provide safe water.
Yeah.
The people of Chinsali, you become an example of the fact that such projects, when they are implemented, and our people begin to receive clean and safe water, reduce diseases.
Yeah.
At least you are not reporting anything in terms of cholera, typhoid.
No. Those are for Osaka.
It's just a foreign, the foreign disease of COVID.
Yeah.
And I think we can afford to congratulate His Excellency for a job well done, to have been pushing and passionately committed to have this infrastructure put in place. Minister, there was information about encroachment. There is somebody that people seem to be suggesting that he is politically connected, and therefore they are, playing around the area where the infrastructure is put.
Mm-hmm.
So I was asking.
You're playing around this place.
Yeah. So I was saying to myself, I said, that person, they are politically connected to heaven, or where? Who are they connected to?
They must be politically connected to these UPND guys.
Maybe, because a person who is responsible, this kind of infrastructure, even if yourself had a legal document that suggests that you are somewhere around there, just a sense of responsibility to show you that what you're doing will affect many, many thousands of people in the
community. By the way, the banks from somewhere they are going to aside. They are free to occupy that land.
Right.
But not near there.
So those are some of the things that Minister maybe would request that follow up so that your infrastructure remains safe.
Is protected.
Yeah, Honorable, for sure we have that challenge. Just at the entrance when you are entering the dam, there is this individual also on the other side of this vicinity. We engaged the council, being the owners of the land, that they demarcate the land for us, and we start the process of the title. Mm-hmm. So they are yet to give us a quotation, and so that process can start. If he has encroached, we are not going to mind about any documentation that he has, because we need to protect the lives of people for the future.
Right.
And then also the backflow for this dam is actually over 50 meters, so it goes beyond just about 50 meters from here.
Okay.
So also we need to protect this land. Yeah, of course, we have the Kapwepwes family who have land on the other side. Those we can easily negotiate in terms of how much they can protect this dam.
I can assure you that you have a very able minister of the province.
Sure.
For me here, Even when I received that report, I was very sure that that is a small matter.
Yeah.
I just needed to bring it to his attention to be cleaned
up. Yeah, need to be cleaned up. And then also, the other thing I must say is that you don't need to start preparing quotations and what. Chambeshi is a utility company formed under the act of a government, this government. And also, there is a provision in our statutes that if, for example, you need land to set up offices, you don't go to pay. Government cannot pay to itself. So the council is supposed to provide those provisions. The surveyors in the council are on salary because of your presence. So now that I've known, the instruction will be you constitute a team. You make allowances, maybe lunch allowance, what, for those who are on the ground working. Yeah, even when they do the maps, they are not going to value that land for Chambeshi to buy. Government cannot buy from itself. That's not how we operate. Yeah.
So, thank you very much.
So going forward, I think Mr. Mwash, the council should provide surveyors this week, next meaning starting next week, in liaison with Chambeshi, and they need to come down here, put. GPS phones and make put beacons so that we protect the facility. But also, let's not take everything. You leave some spaces for development. As Chambeshi, we are using 1% of the water. So 99% is still running idle. In the next 15 years, we'll get to 2.5 or 3%. So the remaining water should not just be going for hippos to go and drink. No, we need to have social activities developed around this place. Towns that are in between rivers are just the best. Yeah.
Taken.
All right.
So thanks very much, Honorable Minister.
So let's go. Thank you for another problem.
He wants to block him.